Hello, welcome to this video. In this video, I will show how to create attendance sheet by using Openpyxl library in Python. First, let us see how this program works. I saved this Python file on my desktop by creating a folder named as attendance sheet. In that folder, we can find two documents. First one is Python file and second one is Excel workbook. This workbook consists of single worksheet which is named as input. There we can find some student names which starts with first student and ends with last student. So first I am going to execute the program. Close the Excel workbook. Press F5. Now I am entering minimum month number, so I am entering 1. Now I am updating max month number. I mentioned as 3, means I am going to generate the attendance sheets from January to March. Here I am updating as 2019. So I am creating 3 worksheets from January to March for the year of 2019. Press enter. Now we can find days and dates data from January 2019 to March 2019. And also at the end application printed as execution completed. Here we can find the data. January, February and March. Now we can find the same data in Excel workbook also. Open the Excel workbook. Here we can find 3 worksheets, January 2019, February 2019 and March 2019. And dates from January 1st to January 31st. And also you can find relevant days also. All the cells filled with P. P denotes about present except Sunday column. Now let us execute the same program once again. Close the workbook. Press F5. This time I want to retrieve the dates of April month for the year of 2018. Press enter. Open Excel workbook. Here we can find all the 2019 attendance sheets deleted and April 2018 attendance sheet newly added after input worksheet. Means whenever we re-execute the program, application deletes all the existing Excel worksheets except input worksheet. Here we can find the student's data starting from first student and ending with last student. Make sure to enter the student's data from A3 cell only. And as it is dynamic, you can add n number of students. Now let us see the coding part. First, import the libraries into Python. Next, define the workbook path and load the workbook. Right click on workbook. Click on properties. This is the location where the workbook exists. You can place this workbook anywhere in your system. After copying the path, copy the Excel workbook name and provide the extension
we can find the extension here itself, XLSX. After that, I created a variable for workbook and subsequently loaded the workbook into that variable. Next, I defined variables for min month, max month, and year, and stored the values through input function. Next, I created two lists. First one is for day names in a week from Monday to Sunday. In Python, Monday count starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And in another list, I stored maximum number of days in a month. January month consists of 31 days. February month consists of 28 days. March month consists of 31 days. And so on. December month consists of 31 days. Next, define variable for input sheet. After that, define object for font style. Here font denotes, which is imported from openpyxl.styles. Once we open bracket, we can find all the available properties. Here I started try block. In the try block, first condition is, if min month is greater than max month, raise value error. In exception block, I provided the description. Now let us cross check once. Press F5. Here I am providing min month as 5 and max month is 2. This is for 2019 year. It provides the description as min value should be less than max value. Next, I created a for loop and provided the condition to delete all the existing sheets where sheet name doesn't consist of input. Next, I created one more for loop here, which is useful to create new worksheets to the respective months. This is the code to create new worksheet. That worksheet has to create after the sheets count. In A1 cell, provided the text as date, and in A2 cell, provided the description as day and applying font styles. And here I have one more for loop. I defined max row in input worksheet. Here max row is 16. In that, I provided the condition to consider student names from the third row onwards. Range count always starts from 0. Here 2 means it denotes about third row. Here I have data from third row. For each and every row, I am adding dates. Range starts from 1. And max number of days considering from the days count list. If r is equal to 0, print the date in first row. Thereafter, mention to provide the font style. Increase the column width to 22. Here provided the horizontal and vertical alignment. If r is equal to 1, print the weekdays and apply the font styles and alignment. If r is equal to greater than 2, and in second row, weekday is not equal to Sunday, print p in all the cells. These are the conditions I provided. Provided the sheet title.
Finally, save the workbook. Print execution completed. This is about coding part. Hope this video is useful to everyone. Thanks for watching.